Hey guys, so today's gonna be a different video. I'm actually not gonna be painting for this video. I just wanted to talk about something that I think is pretty important, especially to growing artists like myself. So, one of the reasons that I don't really like to do tutorials, or why when I make tutorials, I name them something like my way of doing so and so, like my way of painting hair, or like I say that in the video or something, is because I know that I'm not the best source to actually learn from, and I don't want to give out false information and just kind of be like, yep, that's the most accurate thing there is and I'm a great source, you know what I mean? Like, I don't want my tutorials to be like, oh, this tutorial said to do it this way, so if it comes out looking bad, it's your own fault. It may not be, it may be my tutorial, like my tutorials are not that great. But besides that, like in my videos, I like to talk about mostly about how to study. And this video will sort of be like that, except a little bit more interesting, I guess. Or I don't know, it depends on your opinion, I guess. But so lately, popular art is like every young artist's wet dream. They want to paint like Riot or like Sakimi Chan or like those people on DeviantArt that paint really well. It's like hybrid anime-ish realism, not like 100% realism, and it's super attractive to like young artists. Like personally, I really like splash arts from League of Legends, and somebody commented on my video to do a study from Mobile Legends, which is basically like League of Legends but for mobile, and they also do splash arts, and they're a little less sophisticated, but they are also surprisingly really good for a mobile game. So I am going to use those and Riot's splash arts as an example throughout this video. But yeah, I've just seen that it's very popular to try to mimic these styles, but I'm just here to sort of warn you when you're studying or trying to paint in these styles to be very careful and know what you're studying. So I'm going to dive in, bitch. I'm gonna fucking dive in. So I just wanted to start off. This new champion just came out, right? Kai'Sa. And in the forums, there's a ton of like things about her and like talking about her design and all that stuff. And I just want to say something about Riot beforehand. I'm judging this based on their previous high quality splash art, so I do expect quality. So splash arts are supposed to be a representation of the 3D model or the concept, or sometimes one of them doesn't look so much like the other, but considering that the model and the concept art usually look quite similar, the splash art is supposed to be sort of like a glorified version of them, sort of like a poster for the skin or the actual character itself, which is what we have here, a splash art. And you probably, I mean, at first glance, it looks pretty amazing. Like, the rendering's really good, the detail is amazing, the composition is pretty well done, but there are a lot of errors within the perspective and the anatomy of this painting that are actually kind of, they really bothered me that I had to make like a forum about it, or a forum post about it on League of Legends website. And I noticed a little bit, most people agreed with me about the changes and stuff I did, because I did an edit for it, but some people were like saying that people have different body types and like stuff like that, and sort of making it seem like I was trying to body shame, like there was one ideal and they should all look a certain way, but that's actually not what I was doing. I was trying to sort of correct inaccurate anatomy, which is sort of my point here, is that a lot of the times in popular art, we see how well rendered it is and like how sophisticated the compositions can be, well, at least for like a noob artist, and we sort of just like, oh wow, that's so amazing, I want to paint like that. So you will use them as a reference or like as inspiration, but they can lead to bad information. So I'm going to talk about what's wrong with this splash art and sort of like what happens in a lot of splash arts. So it's very obvious that they have a stylized, like a realism slash stylized style in Riot, and based on her concept art, She's supposed to be very feminine, obviously, and curvy. And she sort of has like the average, like sexy female body for games. So based on that, and the concept art looks similar. I'm not sure if I have the concept. Oh yeah, the concept art looks really, really similar to the actual model, and you can tell just by like how much cleavage they're showing that they're trying to make this girl basically the ideal sexy, or give this girl the ideal sexy body. So that's what I'm basing the splash art off of. That she's not supposed to be some contorted, weird creature. Even though she is from the void, she's still completely human structurally and anatomically. So I'm gonna go based on that. And I just wanted to start talking about, like, this isn't an actual skeleton, obviously, but most skeletons do look similar. Like, most references of skeletons will look similar enough that you can sort of use them collectively to sort of get an idea of what the anatomy of a body looks like. And of course, female and male skeletons look pretty different, but mostly it's just the hip width and or the torso, or the rib cage size. And so you can just sort of imagine like the female's rib cages can be smaller, and then their hips are usually wider. But in most cases, like you can see here, the space between the ilium crest, which is the hip, the outer regions of the hip, and then the bottom of the rib cage, before it no longer connects to the cartilage, is really, really, really close. Like in most people, I guess what you would consider the waist is pretty short. It doesn't go very far. Like the hips and the, like almost immediately after in most references. And you want to be going, like when you study anatomy, you want to be going off of what the norm is. You don't want to like stretch, like, oh, I found some this reference, but it doesn't look like the rest of them. You probably don't want to use that one. It's probably not accurate. So in most references, and even in most, just like if it's not a skeleton and you're just looking at a female body, you can see that. Hold on, whatever. I'll just pretend like I have it. You can see that. The end of their rib cage is followed very closely by their hips, and it's that's a very feminine thing. Well, not that it's close, but I mean the hip and the rib cage relationship. Like, the rib cage will cut into the hips, and then the hips will sort of have that curve, and that's what creates sort of like the hourglass shape. And it's like a really desirable thing to have that in art, which is why I found the Kai Sa one so strange. You might not be able to notice it, but one thing that's really strange about her thing is that her waist area is extremely long, and her hips start quite far from her rib cage end, which ends about right there. And so what I did in my edit to raise her hips and to sort of create that hip that starts almost immediately after her rib cage, especially since she's bending sort of backwards, which would close the distance a little bit more towards that end of that side of her body, considering that she's raising that hip up and she's lowering the other one. And there are also other problems. So her neck size is extremely long. Even in my edited version, it may look normal now compared to the other one. Like, oh yeah, that one was a little long, and now that's pretty normal. Actually, her neck is still pretty long compared to the average human female. So this is like the longest neck I could find online. And it's pretty similar to the edit. It might be a little shorter in the actual version, but here's some like other pictures that you can sort of see that necks don't tend to be very long. And this isn't, I didn't search up like short-necked females or anything like that. Like, I wasn't trying to get a bias. I just searched up females. And you can see that necks aren't very long, and her pose would, the posture in which she's sitting at and where she's looking would make her neck shrink even more, because she's looking sort of downwards, which brings your chin down a little bit, which covers more of your neck. Yet still, we get a huge, a pretty large neck. I mean, it even creates a sort of unnatural bend because it is so long. And even if you do the pose yourself, you sort of bring your arm forward and you pretend like you're shooting something and you look towards that arm, you see that the distance between your shoulder and your chin is not that much, yet in the splash art it's quite large, so I noticed that really quickly. And then another problem is that her leg in the front, that's supposed to be sort of moving towards the foreground, is actually really small considering it's supposed to be moving towards the foreground. So I actually enlarged the hat, and you can see that now it sort of does feel like she's stepping forward a little bit. And I also increased the arm size, which she's shooting towards us, so her left, that would be her right arm, but it's on your left. The left arm and the left foot, I just increased their size, so now it really looks like she's actually coming towards you, because before, everything was sort of almost pushed back, so there was a lot of tension within the composition and the perspective itself. You didn't really get that, like, oh, she's stepping forward and she's shooting and she's in the midst of action, where I think that the after really represents that a little bit better. And I just did this with the transform and liquify tool, so of course there's like bends and stuff because liquify, you know, it's not going to be perfect, and the transform tool as well, like it'll disrupt a little bit of things, but overall it created a lot more balance just fixing those anatomical issues and perspective issues. So that's one thing that I would like to say, like, make sure that when you're studying the anatomy is actually correct, because you don't want to deviate from it. You don't want to begin with a deviation. You don't want to study like a deviation of the human anatomy and then try to bring it back to normal. It'll be a lot harder, trust me. If I told you make this version, do like, I don't know what to say, like make her more Gumby like, more spaghetti like, I don't know, like make her neck longer, blah, blah, blah. You'd know how to do that pretty easily. You just have to extend the neck. You could like, or if I told you like make her more feminine, you know like maybe increase her bust size, and decrease her waist size, and increase her hip size. Like these are things that sort of connect, like you know what to do when you want to exaggerate certain features, and that's definitely a choice stylistically, but you need to know what the normal looks like where it comes from, or else your deviations will be exactly that, and they'll be too extreme to be convincing and aesthetically pleasing. Like personally, this is not aesthetically pleasing stylistically in the anatomy, because it's so far from reality that it's like, it just looks weird to me. I'm not convinced that this is a human woman. Well, her face says human, but like her body shape is very monstrous. Like it's uncanny, it's creepy. It's so like, it's close to the reality, but it's not. Here's some like, I wanted to show some examples of good. Oh, I wanted to actually show how I noticed that her splash art is really similar to this one, which is Vayne's Arclight splash art from Riot Games League of Legends. And I noticed like, see, this was a more successful attempt at sort of portraying the female anatomy in like that kind of pose, where the hips and the rib cage have a natural relationship to each other, and the bend is definitely there. It's probably exaggerated, but it's like, it's believable, right? You don't go like, wow, that bend is so terrible, I'm like thrown off by it. Like, it's a believable back lumbar bend. And the arm really looks like it's moving. This one's coming a little further, so that it wouldn't feel like it shouldn't be coming as close to us, because the camera isn't positioned facing her Vayne's fist and her, what's it called, her crossbow, so it shouldn't be as large as the one in Kaisa's. But as you can see, it's even, Kaisa's is even smaller, even though due to this perspective it should be larger, because, and there's more foreshortening, which is good, they did that right, but it definitely needed an increase in size, which is why I increased the size, so it looked like it was coming out a little bit more, which is what I believe they were trying to do, considering her posture and, I mean, everything. Like, you can tell it's an up, we're looking up at her, so. Oh yeah, another thing that was wrong with, or that I saw with the perspective, was that besides the size of her front leg, I'll just call it the front leg because it's in the front, it also wasn't raised enough, so when I brought her hips up, the leg also went up with it, which is good, because when you're looking up at something, things get taller, like they cover, like when you look up at something it looks longer and taller, and it will cover more of, it will sort of raise higher than the horizon, like a little higher than the normal, where it would normally be on the horizon line, based on the horizon line. So I just lifted it up. So now it sort of almost tucks into like the inner corner, the top corner of her knee is coming close to her belly button, which I guess it was before actually, but the belly button was so low that it didn't really, I mean, it wasn't really a good reference point to use. But anyways, yeah, so the vein one is a better example, although I'm looking at this arm and whatever, I'm not like a genius on anatomy, so, or like the best, but yeah. And so I wanted to show other examples of like sort of the popular stylized art, and overall this is pretty successful, I would say, in its like style. It's believable. It's not as sophisticated, and I said that their flesh arts are not as sophisticated because they sort of remove the storytelling element. It definitely becomes like a character poster, whereas in this one you get a lot more story. Like, you see that she's fighting the void, and that she's like in a tunnel or something like that, which is the void. I'm guessing she's in the void right now, and she's like fighting off creatures, and she's surrounded, and you can see like her suit sort of starting to go off in her wings or something, I don't know. But with this one, you started to see like, I'm a magical girl. I don't know what this girl's about. I never played this game, but see, based on just like what I can see, I think she's like a mage, but she also has a sword, so that's a little confusing, and she has like armor boots, but she has a dress, so I'm guessing she's like a mage. And the rendering is really well done, but yeah, and it's like the perspective of it and the anatomy is pretty, it is exaggerated, but it's pretty believable. Like, there isn't anything too criminal, but either way, but even still, like, this is definitely not what you would want to study if you were studying like the real anatomy, which is what you want to usually start with. So like, you can start just by looking at bone structures and real women or males, depending on what you're studying. And I also do have male examples, but here's the thing that usually happens with males. The structure will be fine, like the skeletal structure and the skeleton will be fine, which is why you don't find as much like flaws, but they just increase the muscle mass. So for example, like in this Brom skin, like his waist and his like legs and everything's sort of in the right place, but his mass, obviously his muscles are ginormous, and so I wanted to get like a closer resemblance to him, I guess would be at bodybuilders. And you can see like it's possible in to a certain degree to be that muscular, but they definitely exaggerated that. And that's not too much of a problem. Like, increasing muscle mass is not really that much of a problem because it seems real to us. Like, yeah, you can increase your muscle mass. It's a realistic thing you can do. Obviously, maybe not this much. His, like, lats are fucking ginormous, but it's or his pecs. But it's, like, almost believable because we know that you can build muscle. And, you know, it's still not really realistic, but it's believable. Unlike something like this, it's sort of like, I can't believe that this woman literally has a waist that's that long, you know what I mean? Like, I can't believe that. So it's not very successful in my eyes, which is why, like, if you want to study like muscular men, how to draw them, just look up bodybuilders. That's like the best reference, and you'll definitely learn how to draw accurately and faithfully to real life, which is a good thing. You want to learn how to draw. Everybody says this and it's true. You want to learn how to draw the normal before you go deviate, because like I said, it's so much easier to deviate from the normal than to try to like, than to learn the deviation and then try to be like, wait, what's normal? You don't know, because you don't know what to go back to. Whereas when you know where you start from, you know how to move from that. You know, that doesn't, I don't know if that makes sense, but yeah. Like, for example, you've accidentally, like, sort of built a habit of drawing really long necks because the sort of the references you've been using were inspired by these popular splash arts and, like, artists who commonly do use long necks. Like, it's quite normal for females to have long necks in games. Like, even this neck is pretty long. Like, Here's a picture of a woman who needs to wear, like, I don't know if you guys ever heard of the culture which wears, like, neck braces, and then they've stretched their neck out so long that they actually can't support their head anymore, so they actually need to wear the braces after they've worn them for so long. And they, Karma here and her almost have the exact same length, so that, and here Karma has a brace, which is funny, because, but it actually doesn't reach the top of her head, which would be needed for the actual support, but, yeah, she's at that length that she would actually need support from, like, a brace to hold her head up. And here, it's just even worse, it's even longer. Which is what I'm pointing at. Like, if you learn how to draw with these proportions initially, that's what you're gonna think this is the normal. So every girl you ever draw is gonna have giant long ass necks. Probably the really small waist, but this is actually really believable. And you see here that her rib cage ends up around here and her hips begin around here. See how there's like almost no distance, and you can see it here too. There's like a small space. That doesn't happen here. They end her hip, her chest ends around, or her rib cage ends around here, and then her hips start all the way down here and down here, which is, and this space is like uncanny as fuck, and it looks terrible, honestly. So here's a successful version of like a stylized waist ratio, I guess I could say, but the neck is definitely long, but it's sort of believable. You know, here it's too much. Like, you're like, oh yeah, that's definitely way too long after you've noticed it. So yeah, like I said, like, most of these splash arts, they have super all their proportions are like mildly exaggerated, where their like waists are exaggerated and stuff like that, but in a believable sense. It's still not realistic, but it's like believable. That's what matters, that it's believable. Here's one of my favorite splash arts, and she has a long neck here too. And see, there's a sophistication with this splash art. You can see like the setting, you can see a lot more of the story, whereas in Mobile Legends, it's really just like a pretty picture, which, you know, has its place, and it is beautiful, and I do admire them. Like, I'm not trying to devalue their splash arts, like, they're really well done. I was actually surprised. Because somebody wanted me to look at them and study from them, and I really like this one. I think this one's really well rendered, and it's super cool, like, the perspective and the pose and everything. I'm not sure, like, how accurate it is, because, yeah, I don't really have that much experience with, like, super crazy perspectives and poses, so... But sometimes, like, it can be very obvious, like, with the Kaisa splash art right here. And York, actually, I wanted to talk about York because, like, you can see in the splash art that his body is kind of, like, ginormous and weird, but they have actually based it off of his model, which is ginormous, and then he does have little legs, so in this occasion, like, it doesn't matter so much if it looks weird, because, one, he is, like, a weird monster thing, even though I think he's human, or was, I don't know. But in his model, that's how he looks, so it's representing his model in, like, a realistic way. Whereas in Kaisa, her model doesn't look like what she looks like in her splash art. Which is why it's a crime. Do you see how her ribcage ends right when her hips starts? Her hips start right next to her ribcage. Like, her torso's super long in the splash art, but in the model it's pretty short. It ends right about there, and her hips start and her legs start quite early. So that's why I don't understand. It doesn't look like the concept art, it isn't right anatomically, it isn't, like, I don't understand. I hope they change it, honestly. Yeah, York just has, like, some of the most beautiful splash arts. Like, look at this. Amazing, honestly. Just amazing. Like, the lighting and the rendering and the composition and the storytelling. Like, the hand right here, it's like, wow, and then his hand. Yeah, like, I don't blame anybody for trying to draw, like, these amazing artists and, like, being inspired by them. But definitely know what you're studying. For example, like, if you're gonna go study League of Legends splash arts or Mobile Legends or whatever, any kind of popular artist, just know that you're going there with the intentions to study a stylized image with probably inaccurate anatomy, or at least very stylized anatomy, or maybe not so much. Like, it really depends on who you're studying from, but if you're studying from League of Legends or, like, popular games, or Sakimi-chan especially, like, just know that that's not the real normal body, and you probably want to do real anatomy studies, like, from real people with accurate proportions. So I feel like I took a long time to just kind of get to my point, but what I was trying to say for, well, I guess I covered a lot of points, but so some of my main points were to know what you're studying when you go and look at League of Legends or Mobile Legends or Sakimi-chan or literally almost any artist, because they all have small deviations from reality. And just know that you're going there with the intention to study a style or to study certain gestures that you might like from their art, or maybe they're really successful at using certain colors, or their color compositions or their just compositions in general are really successful, so you want to sort of learn, because that's actually one thing that I do recommend learning from Splash Arts is composition. Like, they have really good dynamic poses and compositions, and oftentimes pretty cinematic lighting and stuff like that. So if you want to know how to like stage a painting and sort of make it look like that cinematic, cool, posterish, splash art-esque artwork, then you definitely should like study League of Legends. But if you're going there thinking like, I'm gonna study from League of Legends, my anatomy, everything, like I'm gonna learn anatomy from League of Legends anatomy and like stuff like that, like sort of expecting to learn anatomy as well from them, I'd be pretty cautious. Like, you'll end up with weird perceptions of anatomy. For example, like, I actually did that a lot. I didn't actually study anatomy. I would just draw like World of Warcraft's books, drawings and stuff like that, or like anime. Everybody goes through their drawing anime phase, and then I went to Splash Arts and I never really studied like the real female anatomy. So a lot of the time, like if you look at my art, the proportions in the neck or like waist or anything like that, it's kind of weird and off, and I never really get that realistic. And it's because I've unfortunately fundamentally fucked myself by never actually studying the reality, although I have recently, which I think has improved my art overall, like anatomy wise and that kind of stuff. So yeah, I just think it's really worth it to go into studying certain things in certain places. So just know when that what you're studying, like, know its purpose. Don't just go there and think, because this is a good artwork, I should use everything from this artwork. It's all perfect. This is all valid information. It may be, but not all the time. Especially because even pro artists make mistakes. Like, I feel kind of like a dick because I feel like I've been shitting on, like, the Kai Saw splash art this whole time. But it's actually a really amazing splash art. Like, it's beyond my level by far. Like, it's amazing. Regardless of the issues, the rendering's amazing. Like, they clearly do know anatomy. It just, like, it can be tricky, especially with like perspectives. Anatomy can sort of slip away from you, especially when you've been working on something for so long and you're just like completely blind to it. Always happens to me. And then, but once you fix it and you do that like before after thing, you're like, holy shit, how did I not notice this? And it's just because you've become blind to it, which really, really sucks. I always say, like, I wish I could look at this with fresh eyes, but I just cannot. So that's why it's, like, awesome to get critique and stuff like that. And even if critique is painful, and I'm sort of going off on a tangent right now, but even if it's painful and it's a hate, it's, like, almost a hate comment, usually they're right. Like, even when it's painful to admit it, like, I'll try what they say, and then it's true. Like, they're usually right. So I would say give every critique a valid chance. And yeah, I hope you guys found this video entertaining, at least hopefully helpful, but at least entertaining, which is not very likely with my videos because I just feel like they're super long and boring. But I feel like this one was more educational and brought out a big issue. I don't know if there's other videos on this, honestly. I don't really watch art videos, like legit art videos where they talk about real problems. I just watch dumb tutorials like everybody else, which is why my art sucks. Actually, I do watch Istabrak, which gives like gives really good lectures and super good constructive criticism and long videos, which are perfect for artists, because I feel like the short ones never give good information or like enough information, but her videos are really good. So honestly, if you want to improve at art, painting, at like in every aspect, she has videos on everything. You just have to look for them, and yeah, I really recommend her channel. So yeah, again, I hope this was helpful, and I'll see you guys in the next video, which, by the way, I have two in the process, but I just, like, haven't been able to finish them. I'm sorry, but yeah, see you guys later.